We are under the lights as the show gets you ready for another edition of Major League Baseball. Ought to be a good one here between the Minnesota Twins and the Oakland A's. In now, Luis Arraez. He'll get us started in this one under the lights. Softly hit to the left side. And there's one away. Now in the box for Polanco for his career in this matchup. Small sample, a perfect one for one. Grounded up the first baseline. But this will get foul. It's a ball and two strikes. Starting to get a bit chilly here tonight. 57 degrees at game time. Lofted in the air out toward right center.
Piscotty
is over to his right as he puts this one away. Two down. At the plate, Nelson Cruz. First chance for him here in the top of the first with nobody on. The 2-1. Is strike two swinging.
Two balls, two strikes.
Got him. And that'll bring in Ramon Laureano. He'll lead things off here in the bottom half of the first. 1-1.
Well, that's off the plate.
Slider misses, and he's in danger of losing him here. 3-1. Swing, line drive. That's going to be trouble. Legs churning. He's headed for second. And he will get there as the A's have themselves a leadoff double.
The second baseman, Tony.
To the plate now, Tony Kemp. There's a breaking ball, but it's laid off and doesn't find the zone. In the dirt here, but it won't skip away far enough for the runner to advance. Laureano stands at second with no outs. Pulls this one into the air out into right field. Right fielder is on the run, and this will kick off the base of the wall. And they're going to take a 1-0 lead as the run comes across to score.
That is good. Not good, Tom.
Stepping in now, Marcus Semien. A bouncer up the middle. And there's one down now. Now at the plate, Matt Olson. And Oakland with an opportunity for more damage here in the first. A 1-1 home. High and deep to right center. Center fielder looking up. And goodbye. This one ain't coming back. In now, Mark Canna. Oh, he had a go at one there, but this is fouled off to the right as the count draws full. Ball strike three called as he couldn't pull the trigger, and there are two away.
Batting fifth.
So bases are empty here with two gone, and that means Matt Chapman will dig into the plate. The short hit hard, reined in. Throw in time, and the side is retired. So the big bat of Miguel Sano digs in next. He'll get us started in the top of the second.
Hey, we're still in the early stages of this one. They're only down by a couple of runs, but it's really key for this leadoff guy to try to get on and get a big inning started.
Full count, three balls and two strikes to the Twins DH. swing and a miss on the slider, and that's out number one. So the bases are empty with one man gone, and here's Donaldson. And it's fouled away. Now the 3-2 pitch. Oh, and he lets him off the hook there, as this isn't even close for ball four. Stepping up now, Mitch Garver. First shot for him here with a runner at first now and one away.
Garver.
Ready on 1-2. Runner at first here, one man out. And the slider gets him swinging, two gone. Stepping into the box, Eddie Rosario. He was one of the stars from yesterday's game as he had three hits in the victory. The 2-1 home. Max Kepler would be next if they can keep this inning alive. To right field and deep. Look at this thing go. Piscotty looks up. And this one is gone. A home run. At the plate now, Max Kepler. Count still at 1-2. And a good take there. Close, but it's 2-2.
Man, this guy's a grinder. Fouls off good pitches and doesn't seem to swing at the ones just off.
A swing and a miss. That retires the side, and that will do it. Striding into the box, Chris Davis. He's set to lead off the home half of the second. Now the 1-1 pitch. A swing and a miss on a ball way out of the zone, and there's one away. Now to the plate, Stephen Piscotty. He'll get to take his first cuts here. A 1-1 home. Misses for the second ball.
He might still be thrown off from that first inning, guys. He got knocked around pretty good, and that can be hard to recover from mentally sometimes.
He's fallen behind now, 3-1. Fouled off. Hopped up. Kepler over to his right. Two gone. Striding in for Oakland, Austin Allen. He had a couple of hits in yesterday's contest. The 1-2. Misses, ball two. And this will miss down low in the dirt, so he's worked it full now at 3-2.
That pitch was way down on 2-2, but give the hitter some credit there. Sometimes with two strikes, you're more off to expand the strike zone.
And we'll have to leave it there as the play is made here to end the inning. The next twin up, Byron Buxton, and he'll start out their half of the third, top of the order to follow. Here's the 2-1 home. In the air out toward right field. Piscotty's there for it. He's got it, one away. At the plate, Luis Arraez. 0-for-1 for him here in this one. Third inning. Already a 3-2 ball game. 2-1 now to the Twins leadoff man. Not an easy pitch to lay off of, but he did somehow, and he's got it to 3-1. Hit softly down the line at first, but this will wind up foul as he runs the count full now. A swing and a miss. He offered it a ball way outside the strike zone for out number two. So bases are empty here with two gone, and that'll bring in Jorge Polanco to hit next. Lifted the other way down the left field line, and this will wind up a foul ball.
This could be a huge win for the guy on the mound if he's able to get out of this inning 1-2-3 and start fresh next inning with the middle of the order.
Semien is there, and the side is retired. So it's back to the top of the order now, and up next will be Ramon Laureano. The 2-1 home. High in the air out to center field. Buxton is right there, one down. One gone for the A's here in the third. And striding toward the plate to hit next, Tony Kemp. The 1-2. And he fouls this one off. Now another 1-2. Liner towards second, and that's in for his second hit of the afternoon.
Up next for Oakland, the shortstop.
So now to the plate, Marcus Semien, fouled away. Here now the 2-2. And this one's in the dirt, but it won't skip away far enough for the runner to advance. The 3-2 pitch. Runners on first with one down. He finally wears him down here as he strikes him out after a 9-pitch at bat. That'll bring up the power hitter, Matt Olson. And remember, he hit that 2-run homer his first time up.
Well, you don't see this very often, Eddie V, a 2-strike straight changeup. But this guy changeup is one of the best in the league. We'll see if he tries that different approach this time. And maybe if he gets to 2 strikes, try to use the fastball a little bit more than that straight changeup. If I'm in the box right now, I'm coming unglued. He is going to throw something over the heart of the plate.
And that'll get down for a base hit.
Now batter, the designated hitter.
Into the box, Mark Canna. To 2 balls and 2 strikes now. Three balls and 2 strikes, a full count to the A's DH.
Well, the guy on the mound, this is one of those innings where nothing comes easy. He's thrown a bunch of pitches, and this AB hasn't been any different. Definitely laboring at the moment.
On to first, and the A's fail to cash in here as the side is retired. Settling in now, Nelson Cruz. He looked to bounce back after striking out his last time up.
Yeah, always frustrating to go down looking. Everybody does it, though. You'll have a few ABs where you get completely fooled. Look for him to be on the attack early in the setback.
And he'll flip it to the pitcher covering for the out.
Now back.
Here's Miguel Sano.
Miguel Sano.
Hot shot on the ground is short. And that's the second out. So bases are empty here with two gone. And that brings up the former American League MVP, Josh Donaldson. From the windup, the 1-1 pitch. A little bit outside. 2-1. This now is hit to second. Does he have another 1-2-3 inning? He does. 7 in a row he's set down now as the side is retired. And that'll bring in Matt Chapman. He's 0 for 1 after grounding out in his only trip to the plate so far. Now the 1-1 pitch. Popped him up. Arias is there for it. And he hauls it in for the first out of the inning. Here's Chris Davis now.
The left fielder, number 2. Chris Davis.
Into the windup. Here's the 2-1 pitch. And he misses low here, so the count goes to 3-1.
3 balls, 1 strike.
Popped up. Arias is there. He hauls it in without any trouble, and there are two away. Outfielder Stephen Piscotty, the next to hit, comes into this at bat 0 for 1 in the ballgame. The 2-2. Is laid off and the count runs full. Austin Allen would be next. And this one misses high for ball 4, and they have themselves a 2-out base runner. Now at the plate, Austin Allen. He got on top of one and was a ground out victim last time. Smoked on the ground up the middle. And the inning will continue as that's through for a 2-out hit. Into the box now, Ramon Laureano. This is line to left, and this is down for extra bases, and with two out, this might get them both home. Tack on another here as the runner scores from second. Homer Bailey answers the call from the pen here in the fourth as they didn't get the outing they were hoping for from their starter. Stepping in now, Tony Kemp. Here's a swing and a miss at the hard splitter, even at 2.
He's having a great day at the dish. His timing is spot on. His pitching staff's going to have to find a different way of attacking him.
Bailey pauses. Here he comes on 2-2. To the left side, scooped up on to first, and that'll do it as they manage to not let this inning get out of hand. All set for the start of the inning. Standing in, Mitch Garver. He was a strikeout victim in his first try.
Sometimes you just got to tip your cap to the guy on the mound. He's getting paid to try and get you out as well. Anytime it gets up there north of 7-8 pitch ABs, sometimes it just comes down to pure execution. Let's see if he makes the adjustment right here.
Center fielder on the run. He makes the catch. A great effort to get there and record the first out of the inning. So coming to the plate, Eddie Rosario. He hit a 2-run jack in his first at bat.
The last at bat, Matty D, we heard this guy's a good fastball hitter. He got a fastball and didn't miss it. We'll see if they pitch him a little bit differently this time and mix in some off-speed pitches.
Bounced on the ground and right at the shifted infielders. And he'll flip it to the pitcher covering for the out. Max Kepler the next to grab a bat. He's 0 for 1 thus far. One and two now as this catches the outer half.
He's in complete command of his two-seamer right now. It's got great movement, great depth, running all over the place. This offense is going to have a tough time.
And this is going to find the alley as it heads out toward Mount Davis for extra bases. And he is in the second with a two-out double.
The center field, number 25, Byron Buxton.
In now, Byron Buxton. High in the air out towards shallow right. In comes Piscotty. He's there to make the play, and that'll retire the side. Bottom of the inning now. Digging in, Marcus Semien. He struck out swinging in his last trip to the plate. 3-2 pitch. Pulls this one in the air out to left. Rosario is there, and he makes the catch for the out. So here's the Oakland cleanup batter, Matt Olson. He's off to a fast start in this one, 2 for 2, including a home run. 2-1 to the A's first baseman.
I got 2 on the count.
Let's see what they throw Olson on, a 3-1 count. 4-2 our score here as we play inning number 5. Back up the middle. He's got it. And there are 2 away now. So now it's Mark Canna. He was a ground out victim last time up. 4 runs, 7 hits, and no errors in the ballgame for the A's so far. And it's 1-2.
That's just a great pitch right there. Great execution. He just got that hitter to think that pitch was knee high. Nasty diving out of the zone.
Again, a 1-2. And this one runs in on him as he can't get his arms extended. A great pitch there, and the inning is over. Leading off the inning, Luis Arraez, and they'll need him to get something going here.
Things not looking very good so far in this one, but we're still in the middle innings. They're down by a couple of runs, and this would be the right place and the right time to get something going. The last thing they want to do is to try to come from behind and win this one in the eighth or ninth inning.
Now ready for another shot now. Jorge Polanco, he flew out in his last at bat. The 1-1. Is laid off for ball 2. Even count, 2 balls and 2 strikes.
It's going to be back to some serious tee work if he can't put that pitch in play right in his wheelhouse.
Here now the 2-2. Liner towards second. And that's in for a base hit. Make it a 1-for-3 game so far. New pitcher coming on now, the right-hander Yusmero Petit. At the plate, Nelson Cruz to 2-2 now. And it's fouled away. Two-two, one more time.
Not a bad time right here to put that runner in motion. 3-2 count. You send the runner, and if it's a bad pitch, it's ball 4.
Another full count offering on its way. And he misses ball 4. So he comes out of the bullpen and immediately walks the first man he faces.
The designated hitter, Miguel Pereira.
1-1. It's a curveball taken low for a ball.
Great chance right here as a hitter to be really aggressive. With 2 guys already on, pretty good shot. He's going to get a challenge pitch right here.
Clearly off with his timing on that one, a swinging strike. Did a good job to shorten up and protect the plate, and he'll have another shot at it here. Big swing by Sano, and a ball sent to deep left field. Gone! So now to the plate, Josh Donaldson. Swing and a long drive again. This one to deep center. Laureano is back to the warning track, and he's able to put it away for the second out. Stepping into the box, Mitch Garver. He struck out and flied out, 0-for-2 so far. The 2-2. Eddie Rosario would be next. Payoff pitch home. And he lost him here on 3-2 as that pitch misses. It's ball four. So stepping in, Eddie Rosario comes in 1-for-2 with that home run he hit earlier. All even now, 2-2. And a half-hearted swing there as they tie him up inside for the third strike, and the inning is over. So that brings up the always intense Matt Chapman. He comes in 0-for-2 thus far. Softly hit out towards short. That gets down, and he's got himself a base hit. Into the box, Chris Davis. Just behind the fastball there, two strikes now. Able to protect the plate with two strikes, and he'll see another one. Ready to deliver the 1-2.
That was a nasty sweeping slider right there. If he was able to just catch the back door a little bit, he would have picked up that backwards K.
In the dirt, but it's swung on for the third strike. And he'll just beat the throw to second. He's in there. And not what they were hoping for, as that moves the possible tying run into scoring position. Now the 2-1 is in there for the second strike. Three balls and two strikes for Stephen Piscotty. And now a slider in there for a called third strike, and there are two gone now. Ready for another chance, Austin Allen, as he'll look to bring home that tying run from second with a base hit into the outfield. Outside, 2-1.
Good time to be a nine-hole hitter right now. More than likely going to get a good pitch to hit. The top of the order is looming on deck. Good spot to be a good hitter right now.
And a split-fingered pitch catches the zone, 2-2 now. Now a shot toward the gap in left center. He's in at second safely, as a run comes across to score on the play, tying the ball game. Standing in now, Ramon Laureano. Good battle, count remains full. 5 runs, 9 hits, and no errors in the ball game for the A's so far. Got him swinging, and that will end the inning. J.B. Wendelken is out from the bullpen now as he'll make his first appearance here on the season. Trying to pick things up where we left off, Max Kepler, 1-for-2 with a double on his line thus far. The 1-2. Lifted the other way out to left center. Davis is under it. Makes the play, one away. Here's Byron Buxton now. Bases are empty, one man out. Swing and a miss on the slurve that time. It's 1-2. Fastball, but that's easy to lay off, and it's back to even at 2-2. Good job to spoil that one away, and he stays alive. fly ball out to straightaway center. Laureano is back, and he'll get there to make the play for route number two.
So the batting order turns over now and set to go Luis Arraez.
He struggled at the top of the lineup in this one, hitless to this point. He's set. Here comes the 1-1. Changed things up on him, and he got him to swing through it. 1-2 now. Hit on the ground for Semien at short. Reined in. Off balance throw. Gets him. Nice play there as the side is retired. Stepping in now, the speedy Tony Kemp. 2-for-3 with a double on his line so far. Now the 2-1. Takes a pitch for strike number two. Two balls, two strikes, a crucial count for both pitcher and hitter. So, Dan, what was your approach on the mound in that count? Do you still pitch for the strikeout here?
Action pitch right here, 2-2. The last thing you want to do is to fall behind the count 3-2.
Swing and a miss on the fastball, and that's the first out.
The batter, number 10.
One out, nobody on. To two balls and two strikes now.
So you'd love for him to offer at that one, but the execution was flawless. Nice curveball that starts in the zone and breaks just out. Just a great take by the batter.
And he'll step on first himself for the out. Count is full. Here's the pitch. A swing and a miss as he chased with two strikes, and that will retire the side. New inning set to get underway. Digging in to try it again. Jorge Polanco is working on a 1-for-3 thus far. And he lays off for a ball, 2-1. In front of the changeup, and he can't keep it fair. Two strikes on him now.
After fouling off the second one, I got to step out of the box, adjust my batting gloves, and tell myself there's no chance he's tripling up on that pitch.
The 2-2 one more time. This ball's hit a ton out to center field. A ball that's carrying. On the warning track, he makes the catch. Here's Nelson Cruz now. The right fielder. Bases are empty, one man out. Check swing, no swing, says the home plate umpire. Ball two. Line to second where it's caught there for out number two. So striding in, Miguel Sano. Bases are empty here with two men out. Taken off the outside as the breaking ball couldn't catch the corner. Takes that one a little bit low. Three balls and a strike now.
When you're playing close games like this, base runners mean everything, so he can ill afford to start giving away free passes.
Wow, this one bounces off the pitcher. No chance to make the play. Let's just hope he's okay on the mound.
The third baseman, number 24, Josh Donaldson.
Stepping in now, Josh Donaldson. Fastball laid off well below the knees. Oh, not cheated on that one. It's 2-2.
Hey, I'd like to see a little bit more discipline than that. You get a count your favorite. He's swinging a pitch that bad? Not good.
Still hanging with him. Another good swing to keep it going. Two out with the possible go-ahead run at first. Fouled off. The 2-2. And he fouls this one off.
You can definitely tell with that foul off right there that he's picking up spin on this pitcher's off-speed stuff. Maybe expect a fastball on this next one.
This one sinks low and a touch outside. It's a full count, 3-2.
3-2, two out, runner on first. Lots of possible outcomes on this pitch.
Too close for comfort, and he did a good job just to make contact. He's set. The 3-2. Hits it high and deep out to center field. Center fielder going back. Gone! A two-run shot that gives them the lead. In now, Mitch Garvin. Now this one is blasted to left field, and there's no doubt about it. Back-to-back jacks. So they'll make a matchup move here and bring on a southpaw to face the left-handed hitter due up. To the plate now, Eddie Rosario. And this ball runs away for ball two, 2-1. With this one almost in the books, the story was clearly the long ball. What are your thoughts on this offense, fellas?
Well, Matty V, I don't know what your thoughts are, D-World, but boy, when the weather starts to warm up and the ball starts jumping out like this, it's clear that the pitchers need to start making better pitches.
Yeah, just great approach. No one really chased today. Really stayed staunch on their ability to get that pitcher to come into the heart of the plate, and they did damage with it.
And now it'll kick around in the corner. And now he'll get into scoring position with two away. At the plate, Max Kepler. High hop, and he barehands it in time. That was exceptional. He got the out and prevented the runner from having a chance to score. Trevor May is out from the bullpen now as he'll make his first appearance here on the season. Stepping in, Mark Canna, 0-for-3 with a couple of strikeouts for him to this point in the ballgame. Maybe too much break on the slider, 2-1.
Hasn't seen a heater yet in this at-bat. One might be coming right here.
He's fallen behind now, 3-1.
If you're at the plate in this situation, you're only thinking one thing, and that is get on base. You got three balls. It has to be perfect over those 17 inches for you to pull a trigger. A walk is as good as a knock right here.
Payoff pitch on its way. Popped him up. Kepler in foul ground. One out. Striding in, Matt Chapman. He singled his last time up. One out, nobody on. Got him swinging. Chased it well out of the zone, and there are two gone. Chris Davis next to bat. He was sat down on strikes in his last at bat.
Yeah, Matty, big time K last time up, and it's been a tough series for him so far. You can tell he's just not seeing the ball off.
Well, the play's been made, and that retires the side. So that'll bring in Byron Buxton. He'll start things off in the top of the ninth as they look for a little insurance. The 1-1. A little roller toward the hole. Throw on to first for the out, and that is how the ninth inning gets underway.
The batter number two.
Now back to the top of the lineup. Stepping in, Luis Arraez, 0-for-4 with a strikeout thus far. The 1-2. Grounded to third. Chapman's got it. And boy, an error saver there at first if he kept his foot on the bag. He did. Oh, what a play for the second out.
into the box or hit Polanco. It was a flyout for him in his last trip. And a fastball, but he's losing it a bit here to 3-1 now.
If you're at the plate right now, you have to realize who's on deck. I guarantee you something's over the heart of the plate. You have to be aggressive in the zone right here.
And this one misses high for ball four, and they have themselves a two-out base runner. And that'll bring up the big stick of Nelson Cruz. He lined out in his last trip, so looking for better fortunes here. He's set. Here comes the 1-1.
Outside, that's the ball.
A runner on first with two away. A little early, and now it's even at 2-2. Hoping to send him packing. Pitch on its way. And he struck him out. So a good pitch there, and now they're going to need to string some hits together in this last at-bat if they want to get back in this thing. Taylor Rogers comes on looking for a save here in the bottom of the ninth inning.
Number 55, Taylor.
Ready now, Stephen Piscotty, 0-for-2 from him so far in this one.
Hey, not impossible, but highly improbable. Even when you're at home to score three runs off a closer like this guy, they've got the work cut out for him.
2-2. And he comes back with one down and in for ball three.
It's been a great job so far by the eight-hole hitter. If he finds a way to get on base, this could spell for a huge inning.
Another full count pitch home. And could this be the start? It's a long way back, but the leadoff man is on base to start their final set of at-bats. Nobody out, runner on first. And that misses 2-1.
Boy, not exactly what you'd like as a pitcher. One of the keys is to minimize your pitches, attack the strike zone early, a lot of deep counts, and working himself into a lot of trouble.
And a good bite to that slider as he swings through it for the first out of the inning. So the Oakland lineup turns over, and to the plate, Ramon Laureano. He's doubled and singled in four at-bats in this contest. It's 2-1 to the A's leadoff batter. Two-one pitch is a sinker swung on and missed. 2-2.
I think it's about time to choke up on that bat and get that foot down. He's awfully tardy right now.
3-2 to the A's center fielder. Crowd gets up for the 3-2. Now here's a check swing, and they appeal down to first. No swing, so that's ball four. Stepping up to the plate, Tony Kemp. He went down on strikes last time up.
Yeah, and kind of shocked he got blown away with a fastball. You could tell he was late on that one. And we'll see if he tries to cheat to something this AB.
Count even at 2-2. Working for the punch out and the offering. Ground ball sent back up the middle. Bare-handed for one. On to first, and he rolls a double play ball to end it here as this ball game is over.
And a nice job here to come in and slam the door. That's his first save of the season, but it certainly won't be his last.
8-5 tonight. The Minnesota Twins get the win on the heels of four home runs. Homer Bailey claims the win out of the pen, his first. Taylor Rogers earns the save out of the bullpen, his first of the year. So that's a wrap here tonight. For Mark DeRosa, Dan Plesac, and Heidi Watney, this is Matt Vasgersian. You've been watching MLB The Show. For more, find us on Twitter, at MLB The Show.
The final line score for our ball game tonight. For the victorious Twins, 8 runs on 8 hits. No errors, they left 4 men on base. For the Athletics, 5 runs on 9 hits. No errors, they left 7 men on base. Time of the ball game, 3 hours and 37 minutes. Thank you for joining us here tonight. And we remind you to please drive home safely.